And I would like to speak and give a voice for every mother who has sent their son or daughter to war. And I would like to specifically speak to my personal experience with my nephew, who thought he was going to be starting his second year at Southern Miss. And yeah, he joined the Guard and paid for school. But instead of going to college, he went to Iraq. And Mr. President-to-be, I'd like you to address the discrepancies between what mothers are told when their son or daughter is going to war and what really happens to that child and what that child is actually called to do. Because there's a real disconnect. My sister-in-law was part of one of these family support readiness units, and they get them all psyched up to support their son or daughter, and that's not what really happens. And my nephew came home, and he's gone back to Iraq again, and now he has chronic and persistent mental illness and will have this the rest of his life. It has torn up the family because they haven't known how to deal with him and his head, and he had to do things in Iraq that they never told him he would have to do. And it's really torn up our family, trying to support this kid. He's unable to hold down a job. He's unable to just function, and he used to be a great kid. So, Mr. President, I'd like to say, don't be bullshitting these mothers, okay? And tell it straight. Don't let recruiters in high schools. Don't let recruiters on college campuses. Let's hear what recruiters have to say out loud and with open doors and taped, so that what our sons and daughters are told before they go to war is actually what happens. Thank you.